In this video, we are going to discuss about network topologies. We know what is a network. Network means a collection of computers which are interconnected together. Let's see what is a topology. Topology specifies how the computers are connected. Mainly we have six types of topologies are there. In this video, we are going to discuss about these six topologies. The first topology is bus topology. Second one is star topology. Third one is mesh topology. Fourth one, ring topology. Fifth one, tree topology. And the last one is hybrid topology. Okay. So here each topology specifies how we are connecting the computers, arrangement of computers. Okay. Let's see the first topology, that is bus topology. In a bus topology, we can have a single cable. So to the cable, all the computers are connected. Here we have six computers, C1, C2, C3, C4, C6. All the computers are connected together with the help of this cable. Okay. Let us assume that C1 wants to send a message to C6. Then it sends the message to C6 with the help of this cable. It broadcasts the message. Okay. It broadcasts the message. So broadcasting means that message will be transmitted to all the computers which are connected in that network. Okay. So C2 has that message, C3 has that message, C4, C5, C6 has the message. Here the advantage here is the message contains destination address. Okay. Here that message contains C6 address. So now C6 will reach that address. So based upon the address, C6 will reach the message. So the remaining computers won't reach the message. Okay. Why? Because that destination address won't matches with these computers, C2, C3, C4, C5. Okay. Now let us see the advantages and disadvantages of this approach. The first advantage is it is very, very inexpensive. Why? Because we require only one cable. So to the cable, all the computers are to be interconnected. The second advantage is easy to add additional computers. Let us assume that I want to add 5 more computers. So simply to the cable, all those 5 computers will be attached. And the third advantage is use less cable. Okay. Here only one cable is needed. So to the cable, all the computers are to be connected. The next advantage is works well for small networks. Okay. It is more suitable for the smaller networks. It supports 100 computers. Okay. Beyond 100 computers, it cannot support that one. Okay. Let's see the drawbacks here. The first drawback is unreliable. Unreliable. Why? Because if this cable fails, then the entire network will fail. Okay. So that's why we can say that this is unreliable approach. And the second drawback is limited number of devices. Let us assume that we can attach only 100 computers to the cable. Okay. So beyond that, it is not possible to attach the computers. And the third problem is traffic problem. There is a possibility that C1, C2, C3 may transmit the message simultaneously to the C4, C5, C6. But here, what we are using? We are using single cable. So through this cable only, that message will be transmitted. So there is too much of traffic here. Why? Because 3 messages are transmitting now with the help of this cable. So these are the drawbacks of this approach. Okay. Now let us see the second approach, that is star topology. In star topology, we can have multiple computers. All those computers are connected to a central point, a central device such as hub. So here we have a hub. So to the computer, to the hub, all the computers are attached. Okay. Let us assume that C1 wants to send a message to C4. Now what will happen is C1 sends the message to hub. Now that message is available in the hub. So from the hub, that message will be transmitted to C4 based on the destination address. Okay. So directly the transmission won't done here. So hub stores the message. From the hub, that message will be delivered to the corresponding destination. Now let us see the advantages and disadvantages. The first advantage is robust. Robust means it is very, very strong. If one link fails, let us assume that this link fails, then the remaining links won't fail. We can use the network. There is no problem. And the second advantage is easy fault detection. That means if there is a problem with a specific system, then we can detect that system very, very easily. Why? Because here all the computers are nothing but some neighboring computers only. If there is a problem with C1, then C2 or C3 can detect that problem very, very easily. And the third advantage is easy to install. Easy to install. Why? Because here we have only one hub. So to the hub, all the computers are to be connected. Okay. Now let us see the drawbacks here. If the hub fails, then the entire network will fail here. Okay. Here the hub is very, very important. Just like in bus topology, this cable is very, very important. So likewise here the hub is very, very important. If hub fails, then the entire network will be collapsed. And let's see the second problem here. Performance is based on the hub here. If hub produces higher performance, then the network will produce higher performance. Okay. If hub produces lesser performance, then obviously the remaining computers and the network will produce less performance. Now let us see about the next one, that is mesh topology. In mesh topology, what will happen is here we have several computers like this, C1, C2, C3, C4, C5. So from each computer, we have links to remaining all the computers in the network. Okay. So from C1, we have links to C2, C3, C4, C5. Next, from C2, we have links to C1, C3, C4, C5. So this is about mesh topology. Okay. So from one device to remaining all other devices, we should have the connections. Okay. Let us assume that if C1 wants to send message to C2, then for that it uses this link only. Okay. Let us assume that C1 wants to send message to C4, then it uses this link only. Okay. Let us see the advantages here. There is no data traffic here. Why? Because from each device to remaining all other devices, we have the links. So with the help of that link, data will be transmitted. So there is no traffic. Okay. And the next advantage is it is very, very robust. It is strong. If one link fails, there is no problem. The remaining links will work, and the network, we can work with the network. There is no problem for the network. And the third advantage is easy fault detection. Here also, if there is any problem with particular system, we can detect that fault very, very easily. Okay. And the fourth one is this approach is very, very secure. Why? Because C1 can send message to C2 with the help of this link. So nobody can watch our data. Okay. Directly with the help of the link, we can share the data. And the problems are, it is very, very expensive approach. Why? Because too many cables are needed. Okay. So here, the formula here is, if there are n computers, then from that computer to remaining all computers, okay, we need to establish the connections. So here the formula is n into n minus 1 by 2. If there are n computers, then we require n into n minus 1 by 2 connections, 2 links. Here what is n value? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 into 5 minus 1 means 4. So 5 into 4 by 2 means 10. So we require 10 links here, okay. We require totally 10 links here. So too many cables are needed. So it is very, very expensive approach. As well as it required more hardware also. Why? Because many number of cables are required. So more hardware will be required. So it is very, very costly approach. And difficult in installation. Why? Because from each computer to remaining all the computers, we have to make the links. So it is very, very difficult to implement this approach also. Difficult to reconfigure. So reconfigure means, let us assume that we want to add some additional computer. So in between C2 and C4, I want to add some C7 system. Then what we have to do? We have to remove this connection. We have to remove this connection. And we have to make the connection like this. Okay. Next, from this computer to remaining all the computers, we have to make the connections. From this computer to remaining all the computers, we have to make the connections. So if you want to add an additional computer, then it is very, very expensive approach. Okay. And the fourth one is a ring topology. So let us see about ring topology now. Ring topology. So ring topology means it follows some links, some ring architecture. Ring architecture. So next we have tree topology, hybrid topology. Let us see about those three now. So the next one is ring topology. In ring topology, what we have is each computer will be connected to its adjacent computers, its neighboring computers. So like we have a computer like this, then this computer will be connected to its neighboring computers like that, okay? And this computer is connected to its neighboring computers. So this is one neighbor and this is the second neighbor, and these computers, these two are connected like this, okay? So let us assume that this computer wants to send message to this computer. Here the transmission of the data is unidirectional. Unidirectional means the data will be transmitted in only one side, okay? So the data will be transmitted like this, okay? Let us assume that this is first computer, this is last computer. Let the computer number is some 10. Let the computer number is 10. So if C1 wants to send message to C10, then it has to travel through the remaining 9 computers, okay? So first the message will be transmitted to this computer. Now this computer passes this message to this computer. Now this computer passes the message to this computer. So likewise the message will be transmitted from one computer to one computer like that, okay? Now let us see the advantages and disadvantages of this approach. The first advantage of this approach is it is very very easy to install. We can implement this approach very very easily. Why? Because we need some cables, so with the help of those cables we can establish the architecture. And the second advantage is it is very very inexpensive approach. It is very very inexpensive approach. Why? Because less number of cables are needed when compared with mesh architecture, mesh technology. Whereas the drawback with this problem is, suppose if one link fails, then the entire network will fail. Suppose let us assume that this link fails. If this link fails, then C1 can't send the message to the C2. So this message won't be sent to C10, okay? And the next problem here is reconfiguration is very very difficult. What is reconfiguration? Let us assume that I want to insert a new computer into the token tree. Let us assume that I want to insert at this position. So now we have to remove these two connections and we have to insert the computer here, and we have to make two more connections like this, okay? So reconfiguring is also very very difficult in this approach. And the next one is tree topology. Tree topology is a combination of bus and star topology. So tree means it is a combination of bus and star topology. So we know what is a tree. Tree means a collection of nodes and it is useful to represent hierarchical information. So here we can have multiple levels. So here we have a cable like this. So this is nothing but a long cable, just like the bus topology. And then it is a combination of bus and star. So star means we can have hub. So this is one hub. This is the second hub. So this is the third hub. So this is nothing but star topology. So we can have multiple computers like this. 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 And this hub is connected to the LAN. Okay. This hub is connected to this cable. So next we can have multiple computers which are connected to the hub, okay? So here the transmission will be done just like star topology and bus topology. But here the major advantage is if one link fails, then there is no problem here. Why? Because this hub, if one link fails, then what will happen? The remaining star topologies, the remaining hubs will work. There is no problem here. Let us assume that this hub fails here. If this hub fails, then there is no problem. So we have two more hubs. So we can transmit the data with the help of those two hubs. Coming to the advantages and disadvantages, tree topology has the advantages of bus and star, as well as tree topology has the disadvantages of bus and star topology. And the last one is hybrid topology. Hybrid topology is a combination of all these topologies. So it is a combination of bus and star, or star and mesh, or bus, star, mesh, ring, tree. So according to our requirement, we can combine two or more topologies, that is called as hybrid topology. So this is about network topologies in computer.